second speaker, Mike Pelech, and make sure to pin your timer and follow the time. And Mike Pelech today is going to talk about herding cats and what I learned being a VPM. Well, we might think about herding cats, but his speech is from visionary communication. So we will hear some visionary thoughts and ideas about herding the cats, what I learned being a VPM. Please welcome Mike Pelech on the stage.
Thank you very much, Madam Toastmaster, dear fellow members, honorable guests. Roughly 1 year ago, I nominated myself for VPM position. I successfully delivered a speech and I became VPM. When I became VPM, I told myself, Mike, brace yourself. You have a journey ahead. And one interesting thing I find out when I start thinking about my experience of being VPM and about leadership in volunteering organization, it's like herding the cats. You know, they are really nice animals. They are really individual animals. Every cat has his or her own way of doing things and presenting himself and thinking about world. But to organize a pack of cats, it's really, really hard task. Especially because this is not hierarchical organization. This is not private company, and you have no incentives like salary and things like that, right? And I got three quite interesting lessons learned from my experience of being VPM and herding cats for the club. First lesson learned, focus on big things. We are a really small team. It's just three person who are really communicating between each other and pushing a lot of things. It's VPM, VPE, and VPPR. We also have great secretary, we have great treasurer, and we have president. But in any team, you have three phases: storming, norming, and performing. However you like your colleagues in your team, you always face some conflict at the beginning. And the only way to survive this is to focus on the big thing, why we are doing this, why we are having this discussion, why this person is doing this comment. And sometimes you have to think, and you find out the person is doing comment which you dislike, not because person dislike you, but because he or she would like to achieve something bigger and something better. So this is very important lesson learned, that when we have a discussion, I always try to focus on big why, what we would like to achieve, what is important for club. So be like this cat, look up and focus on big things. Second, very important is active listening and understanding other point of view. Being VPM could sound like a piece of cake, right? You have an instruction, you handle this brochure to guests during the meeting and say, "Hey, we are great, join us, we have Oscars." But really, why people are coming to club, what they are looking for, what are their needs? And to understand this, you have to do quite a lot of active listening and trying to step in people's shoes and see what are their needs. And you could find out that people have really, really different needs and different approaches why they are coming to club. And for some people, pathways could be a really good thing, but some other people would prefer to take roles first. Some people would like to run fast for a DTM position, but some other people are more interested in winning on contests. So understanding through active listening is very important. And sometimes I've heard that leadership is about speaking and giving directions. Guys, we are going there or here. I find this is not true. Leadership is about asking a lot of questions. When you ask people five times why, you get to understanding and you start seeing the big things. Last but not least, implementation beats the ideas. When I joined the team, I had a gazillion of ideas. And I think Irina could confess, officers meeting with my participation was a torture because I came with a gazillion of ideas. Every idea is brilliant and really lovely. What I found out that implementation is more important. You could start with a small idea, but when you implement it and make it running smoothly, not perfectly, but smoothly, it makes a lot of impact on the club. One example is Quizmaster role, which I tried to introduce to the club because I witnessed it in some other clubs. And I thought this is a really good thing because it helped people to stay focused during presentation, which is extremely important during Zoom era. When you are in a club, you have few, if any, distractions. But when you are in Zoom, you have next window of Facebook or whatever, and you could be easily distracted. So Quizmaster is a really essential role because it helps people to focus on the substance of the meeting. So when we managed to introduce and run this Quizmaster role and run it quite smoothly, I felt like, yes, this was a great idea, but this was a great idea implemented. All in all, I would like to conclude with one thing. One great thing about Toastmasters is this is a club which is run by people. So if you would like to make something different in a club, to help club run smoothly, nominate yourself for one of the positions. And you will have an opportunity to herd the cats and learn a couple of valuable lessons in leadership. Thank you very much, Madam Toastmaster. The floor is back yours.